Hello, I'm Venket Venkipuram, Senior Pre-Sales Consultant with Axway, and I'm here to talk about Axway's Managed File Transfer solution. What is Managed File Transfer? It is a software or a service that automates the exchange of data files between and within organizations. Today, we will be going over some of the common MFT flow patterns. Then we shall review a typical deployment architecture. We shall then pivot to a demo which is oriented around a common use case wherein an external partner uploads a PGP encrypted file into the Axway MFT gateway, which is then decrypted and routed conditionally to the correct backend system. We shall then round this off by going over what we have seen. Let's hone in on common MFT flow patterns. We can look at it from three different dynamics. You have your partner ecosystem with whom you're exchanging files through the firewall. This forms the basis of your B2B flows. And then we move on to the internal ecosystem, wherein you have your various systems and applications running on different platforms altogether. They need to exchange data files as well. This forms the basis of your app-to-app transfers or system-to-system transfers. Then you move on to the third dynamic, the ad hoc or the human dynamic, wherein you need to be able to collaborate, share content in an easy and self-consuming way, either internally or externally with your colleagues or individuals outside of your enterprise. This could be a combination of different things, wherein the exchange is between systems and humans or humans and humans. Let's take a brief look at a typical Axway MFT deployment architecture. Your external partners at the right side of this image are transmitting data files to Axway MFT Data Exchange Hub via the DMZ. The Data Exchange Hub brokers the exchange of data files between your internal applications and your external partners. The DMZ is where Axway's Edge proxy solution is installed. This is a zone that contains no data, hence securing the backend data hub from any security threats. The data itself is secure in transit and in rest. The footprint behind the firewall, where the MFT data exchange hub is installed, becomes the reverse proxy to the external world. This is a secure zone, and this is where your external partners and your internal applications will be logging in to exchange data files. The data exchange hub also hosts the rules engine that automates all of the workflow processing. As your data traffic and partners grow, you would need to scale this installation as well. This installation can be scaled easily with multi-node clustering. Moreover, most of the MFT actions that can be performed via the web-based portal or file-based clients can be achieved by use of Axway's APIs. Axway's APIs can easily integrate with your ITSM applications, and your core technical team doesn't have to learn the inner workings of Axway MFT in order to use it. Axway MFT has a customizable role-based administrative tool that enables self-service, and you can easily extend this to be used across various teams, making it a shared service. We shall now transition to the demo. This demo will be oriented around a common use case. We have a partner who is uploading a PGP encrypted file into the Axway MFT gateway using SFTP protocol. This file will then be decrypted by the Axway MFT gateway and routed to a backend application. I'm going to show you the demo from three different perspectives. I'm going to begin by onboarding this new customer. This will be executed through the eyes of an end user in self-service fashion. I shall then pivot to explaining the rules engine, how we do the automation, not just to ingest the file, but automatically PGP decrypt the file and route the file to where they need to go. We shall then take a look at the runtime dynamics of operational visibility and tracking. So some of the key themes that we will be seeing are how we can eliminate the scripting and the execution of the workflows and processes in a much more streamlined, simplified, and automated manner. We will look at self-service concepts, how we can put these capabilities into the hands of the end users. We will see how this platform can be made flexible and extensible. We will also look how operational efficiency can be realized. Okay, so let's go into the first part of our demo. We have Amy, who belongs to the line of business, and she isn't tech savvy. She wants to onboard a new customer into the MFT gateway, so that's the experience I'm going to be showing you. We will then verify the setup and see if it is working. We shall then proceed to subscribe this newly created customer to an already existing workflow. Let's switch to the product. The administration interface is web-based, and I'm going to log in as Amy. This is Amy's view of the gateway administration interface. Her view is limited to the business unit that she's a part of, and that is accounting. This is where Amy is going to onboard and set up a new customer in the MFT gateway. Amy can manage the users, also referred to as accounts. An account is a representation of a customer or a partner. Let's create an account. Let's click on the new account button. Let's specify an account name, test 1, 2, 3. Then some grouping parameters. Here, some of the other settings are here. Then we can choose to enter a password so that the account can authenticate against a local server. We can also choose to have the account authenticate to an LDAP, but we will choose a local server here. Hit save. Now this account is created. Let us now verify the setup by logging into the user portal as a newly created customer or partner. This is the web-based experience. So once you've logged in, you land into your mailbox. This is where we can upload files. So this file has been uploaded, but this file doesn't go anywhere because there are no rules specified to automate the processing of this file. We will now look at the file upload experience via a SFTP client. So we will be logging in as test 1, 2, 3. And once we've logged in, we can upload files via this SFTP portal. So as you can see, the file gets uploaded to the same mailbox which we had used earlier via the web-based experience. Amy can now log into the administration portal and view the uploads executed by the customer. So in the file tracking tab, she can view the file uploads using the web-based portal as seen here on the HTTP protocol or the SFTP client or the SSH protocol. We will now look at how easy it is to subscribe an account or a customer to a pre-existing workflow. Once we are in an account, we select the relevant application and then the route. So we can select the upload folder to be inbound. So all files coming into this folder inbound execute this route sample. So once we add this route, we are all set. A route is a set of rules or instructions on how to process the ingested file. So let's take a look at our route here. So this route here actually contains a simple step that publishes the ingested file to another folder. Customizing this route is easy, and you can add additional steps from a list of predefined transformation or routing options from the dropdown. Okay, so let's net out what we saw here. We saw the idea of creating a self-service administration model where we are putting these services in the hands of the line of business teams. So by doing so, you're reducing this burden on your core technical team so you can bring down the cost of shared service. The other component is the rules engine that we just saw. This enables you to create rules that automate the processing of files. We can package it into reusable components so that Amy doesn't have to worry about creating these rules or patterns all over again. The outcome is that you can speed up the onboarding process and gain efficiency. In this part of the demo, we will delve a bit deeper into the rules engine. We'll take a look into a PGP decryption workflow and execute a sample workflow. This workflow will decrypt an incoming PGP encrypted file and route it to an external server. Let's switch to the product. We have another user, Bob Builder, who is subscribed to a workflow that decrypts an uploaded PGP encrypted file. As you can see, this subscription picks up the PGP encrypted file from the folder inbound and then kicks off a route PGP decrypt send. Let's take a quick look at this route. PGP decrypt send route consists of two steps. The first step is the PGP decryption step, and the second step is the file transmission step. The file transmission step transmits the PGP decrypted file to an external SFTP server. This external server is listed under the Transfer Sites tab for Bob Builder. This is essentially a library list of external server that Bob Builder can pull or push data files. Let's upload a PGP encrypted file and observe the workflow. Let's log in as Bob Builder into the web-based portal. Once logged in, we can upload the PGP encrypted file into the inbound folder. This file has been picked up. Now that the PGP encrypted file has been picked up, Amy can view the progress of the transmission from the file tracking tab. We can see that the PGP encrypted file was successfully decrypted and transmitted to the external server. Let's go back to the PowerPoint deck and net out what we saw. Again, this is a different persona, potentially a member of the technical team who configures the automated workflows. As we saw, we were able to automate the processing of data files. We are moving away from the concept of scripting, but the Axway framework is flexible that we can integrate your native scripts to be a part of the automated rules engine. Let's now focus on the final part of the demo, which is runtime operational visibility and tracking. What do we do to ensure that the file transmissions are executing as expected? Let's quickly switch to the product. Let's look at the PGP decryption workflow that we kicked off earlier. As observed through the course of this demo, Amy can monitor this transmission via the file tracking option in the administration interface. But this is very limited in what it can do. It shows the progress of the file transmission where the file was ingested and PGP decrypted to the outbound step where the decrypted file was transmitted to the external server. As we expand on the inbound steps, we can observe the technical details of the file ingestion. The PGP decryption step is also included in this view. We can also view the outbound step, wherein the PGP decrypted file was transmitted to the external server. As you might have observed, this is a very technical-oriented view in terms of the information presented. However, all of the information going through the gateway application is published to Axway's operational visibility and analytics platform. This platform contains prepackaged dashboards that can present the information in a consumable manner. This platform can be enabled to perform trend analysis, end-to-end monitoring, proactive alerting, and SLA management. The platform also learns about file transmission patterns, so you can be alerted in case of a pattern mismatch. Moreover, non-technical stakeholders can seamlessly interrogate the status of the file transmission without the involvement of the core technical team. Let's now take a look at Axway's operational visibility and tracking platform. We are now looking into some of the pre-built dashboards here. With these dashboards, you can get a deeper understanding of the data transmissions flowing through the MFT gateway. In case of the internal transfers view here, we will be able to evaluate the day-to-day normal transmission patterns against what is expected. This is trend analysis in action. The blue line represents the file transmissions that are occurring right now versus what is expected, which is represented by the gray line. These dashboards learn over time with enough data. You can set up alerting based on observed pattern, and you can be alerted in case of any file transmission abnormalities. Another feature is the DVR-like view, wherein you're able to go back in time and view events. This might be useful in triaging disruptions and analyzing business impact. We can now look into punctuality checks. This view here keeps track of your scheduled transmissions and checks if the transmission has met its deadline. This could be an event or a non-event. Let's now take a look at the failures dashboard. This out-of-the-box dashboard here showcases the failed transfers and related information like accounts and protocols. You can build a custom solution that could hook up non-Axway products so that you can get a global view. You can click on one of the failures here and get more context on the failure. There is an option to resubmit failures right from this dashboard, which might be valuable for a non-technical business user. You can also use the powerful transfer search feature, which requires little to no technical expertise. In summary, what we observed was that we can gain cost and operational efficiencies by eliminating scripting and adopting Axway MFT Gateway's workflow automation. We also saw the benefits of self-service that enables citizen integrators to perform routine tasks without the involvement of the core technical team. This can be rolled out to multiple teams, thus making it a shared service. We also learned about the various capabilities of Axway MFT's operational and visibility platform. Overall, Axway MFT Gateway can help realize cost savings and operational efficiencies.